town still asleep.
Like we should be. There's Bannister's place.
Who's the man in front of the saloon?
Just a man in front of a saloon. Who cares?
Richie? Mr. Dan Ritchie?
That's right.
I've been waiting for you.
You live around here?
No.
But you're waiting for me.
I was in Ellsworth. I heard you was coming to Mesa.
Why should that interest you?
My name is Robles. David Robles. You remember the name?
I heard the name. Every year there are at least five loudmouths with a few notches on their guns. You hear their names. Most of them die before you get to meet them. Go on back to Ellsworth, Robles. I don't want to kill you. Go on to your glory someplace else.
Mr. Dan Ritchie.
Gotta force it, huh?
You remember Del Rio 5 years ago?
I remember Del Rio. Not you.
Oh, I was there. So was you. So was Thomas, Tharp, and Bentley.
They're dead.
Yeah, I know.
You? You waited a long time for this, didn't you?
Took me 5 years to learn to use a gun.
All right. Count to three.
One. Two. Three.
You?
Before you say anything, mister, think it over.
It's Dan Ritchie.
Is there a doctor in town?
You out, Drew Ritchie. I don't believe it.
Would you like to go to hell and ask myself?
Well, if you don't mind, I should make a report. Your name is,
Robles, David Robles.
This boy needs a doctor. Quit playing like a sheriff, Tillman. Go on, vamos.
Well,
Name's Ed Bannister, son.
You a doctor?
No, but I'll be glad to show you where the doc lives.
You know, any man can outdraw Dan Ritchie. I got a lot of respect for.
I sent for him to come up here for a little talk a couple of weeks ago. Then you have to go kill him as soon as he gets into town. I ought to be mad at you. But like I say, you got my respect. I can't be mad at a man I respect.
You must have been quite a friend.
Oh, gunfighters got no friends except other gunfighters. You mean you never heard of me, Ed Bannister?
No.
That's strange. Why, boy, when I hung up my Colt, there was 14 cuts on the handle.
Yes, sir. First time I ever drew on a man, I was only 16.
Right in there, boy. Oh, Doc. Hey, Doc, you got business.
I'm not deaf. I heard the shots. What am I today, doctor or mortician?
Both. You patch up this one and you bury the other one.
Thanks for the trade, Bannister. Both friends of yours, I take it.
You two gonna talk while I bleed to death?
Get up. Up. Over here. Sit down. Let's see it. Unbutton the shirt.
How is it, Doc?
Too bad. It's only a scratch.
Well, Davy boy. Why don't you come up to my place after Doc fixes you up? All you want to drink on the house?
Yeah, I might do that.
Fine. Take good care of him, Doc.
Who'd you kill?
Oh, Dan Ritchie.
Oh, him. Who are you?
Dave. Robles.
That's fine. I'll remember the name. And when somebody kiddles you, I can also say, oh, him. Hold still. Good morning, Estella.
Good morning, Doc.
This one's ready for bandaging, and the other one's ready for burying. It's only a flesh wound. Put some carbolic acid on it and a nice bandage.
Will it hurt much, Doc?
Not as much as a rope around your neck.
He's very funny.
Take off your coat.
Why doesn't he stay and take care of me?
Take off your coat. I said...
Well, I'm not used to women doctors.
Did you ever hear about soap?
Yeah, you're very funny, too. This whole town's funny.
If you'd rather see tears, why don't you ride and find the family of the man you just killed?
What do you know about the man I killed?
Just that he was a man who was killed. Is there more to know?
Yeah, you ride to Del Rio. See how many people are crying because Dan Ritchie's dead.
But I do not live in Del Rio. I live here in Mesa. And I charge $1.
I'll have to owe you. You don't believe I'll pay you, huh?
Yes, I believe you.
Ken, let's get a box ready for Ritchie. I'll give you a hand. Breezy, come back here.
Oh. Later, Doc. Hey. Mr. Robles. Mr. Robles, I took care of your horse. Yeah, I'm the one who took care of your horse. Got him all rubbed down and fed, even before we took care of Richie.
Much obliged.
Well, anything I can do for you, Mr. Robles, you just say the word.
Thanks.
Oh, thank you. Anything at all. Mr. Robles, folks around here call me Breezy. Breezy Morgan.
Fine, Breezy.
Ah. So you're all patched up?
Yeah.
Guess I was pretty lucky at that, huh? Welcome to the friendliest spot in Mesa. What's your pleasure?
Well, whiskey, I guess.
Yeah, make it two, will you?
On your way, Breezy.
Oh, no, Ed.
I can't you bother Mr. Robles here. I'll twist your nose off.
Give him a drink. He took care of my horse.
Want to keep an eye on him, Davy? Sure, he'll do you a favor if there's anything in it for him.
Oh, no, Ed.
Trouble is, he'll do anything again here for the same reason. Here's your drink, Breezy. Drink it and scat.
Much obliged, Dad. You too, Mr. Robles.
You know, one of these days I'm going to treat you to a drink.
Yeah, I will. But I got a claim staked out west of here. You know, me and a friend. One day it's going to pay off.
He's been mooching drinks with that story from everyone in town.
You believe me? don't you, Mr. Robles?
Well, I believe you, Breezy.
Drink up, Davy boy, to a pleasant stay in Mesa. You're gonna like it here, boy. Nice place to come to and take it easy. You've had your drink. Get out. Go on, get out. You'll be in good company soon enough, Davy. Some friends of mine ought to drop in any minute. Fred Jasper and the Dawson brothers. Name's familiar?
Oh, I heard of them. Why are they coming here?
I asked them to, like I did Richie. They all like it here.
Hard to see why. It's a pretty dull town.
Davy boy, a gunfighter's not very welcome most places. He's got to keep one eye on the law and one on the vigilantes. But here, a man can relax, drink all he wants to, see old friends, and not worry about the law. Here. Your card. Dave Robles. There. Now you're one of the boys.
There's quite a few cards up there.
You bet. You should see the names in those cards. Some of the fastest guns this side of St. Louis. Go on. Put your mark on it.
Okay.
Now wait. Use my gun. Go on, try it.
It's quite a gun.
That gun, in its time, commanded a lot of respect.
Only. It's too quiet around there.
Well, Marshall's locked up half the town.
Well, you won't find any prodding lawman around here.
Hey, can you remember when the cowherds came up this way? It was quite a town.
I can't figure a man like you in a dead town like Mesa.
Well, maybe I mean to bring it to life. Let's have a little fun first. Then we can sit down and have a long talk. I got an idea you boys might really go for. Well, Dave, come on over here and meet my friends. Boys, this here is Dave Robles. This is George Dawson, his brother Billy, and this ugly old cuss is Fred Jasper.
Hi.
Robles, huh? Didn't you have a run-in with Bob Tharp last month?
Just outside of Dodge.
Who cares about Tharp? Dave here got himself one of the best this morning.
Huh?
Dan Ritchie.
You got Dan Ritchie?
Well, I,
Mister, I drink this one to you. I seen Richie draw before. Psst, fast as a cat.
Hope you can stick around for a while, Dave.
Well, I got no reason to stick around.
Well, you're among friends, boy. Any man can gun down Richie, huh, Fred?
You bet. You won't want for friends around here, Robles. When word spreads that you got Richie, you just watch how the folks smile on you. But keep to your own kind, boy, like us.
That's right. Drink up, Dave. Where else can you find free drinks in a friendly bunch like this?
You keep pouring, I'll keep drinking.
Think that looks tight enough, Doc?
I guess so, Ken. You feel like doing some digging?
I'm sorry, Doc. Old Matt Logan needs his horse shot by noon, I promise. Sure, I'm sorry.
Breezy around.
Ain't seen him.
Well, you never do when you need him. He promised to help me with the digging. All right, Ken. Let's load him up.
All right. Doc, you got a minute?
Hello, Ken.
We have to talk to you, Doc.
If you got a few spare muscles, give us a hand.
Sure.
Nice box, Ken.
Thanks. Ken, you better get busy with old man Logan's horse if you're going to make any money.
I'll help you with the box, and I'll sell Richie's pony a saddle and split it with you, Doc.
Well, that's fair enough. Let's lift.
Doc, about this trouble...
Now, come on, Tom. Let's get to work.
What's on your mind, Roy?
Bannister and this.
We've let it go far enough, Doc. When Bannister rode in here a month ago and opened that place up, I said right off we're in for trouble. You remember that? Exactly what I said. We're in for trouble.
Tom, you are a living prophet. You really are a living prophet. But you talk too much. Put your end in first.
See you later, boys. You gotta be serious, Doc. All Bannister's done for the past month is liquor up any riffraff gunman he can get to pass this way. No man opens a saloon, then spends his time giving away stock.
I'll be darned if I can figure it out either. And until I can, I don't aim to kill myself worrying about it. You boys want to come along to the funeral?
No, thanks.
Let's force Jack Tillman to do his duty as sheriff.
It's getting hot, boys, and I got some digging to do. Let's talk about it again, huh?
Breezy, where have you been?
Oh, come on!
Coming, Doc, coming.
We'll see you later, boys.
Let's find Tillman.
Get rid of Bannister, you big flippy.
Come on his leg, Jack.
I'll find it. Rest of the bad. You got it.
Mr. Jasper. Do you mind?
One of you boys better miss it. We'll be drinking out of tin cups.
Tell me.
Hey, Fred. I'll be darned. If he don't have one of those pretty tin stars, just like the one we took off that nice man in Silver City, remember? You think we ought to make it a pair, huh?
Let's have a drink. Over here.
Hey, Fred, he can't drink. He's on duty.
Duty.
You're on duty, huh? You come in here to do your duty, huh, Fred?
Now, boys,
Come on, fellas. We was having fun before. Well,
yeah.
We can have fun with Jack here, can't we, Jack?
I'll come back later. I got something else to do.
Well, why don't you stick around here with us?
Sure, Dave. Fun's just getting started.
Ed, I want to go and see a girl.
A girl?
Davey, you're coming to the wrong town. You got to go to Dodge or Wichita.
He's right, Davey. You're wasting your time. There isn't a decent white woman with an...
Yeah.
Oh, come on, Davey. You're not leaving town, are you?
Look, if I want to go, I go. If I want to stay, I stay. Did I tell you?
Well, I'm your friend, boy.
Like you was Richie's friend?
That's a type should never drink.
Are you in a bad mood, Mr. Higgins?
Not Jack Tillman.
Oh.
Send him into that rat hole across the street and he stays there. Probably telling those saddle tramps how nice they are.
What we need in this town is some force. We can't just go on and on.
Oh, I like this. But I don't think red is good for her. Do you have the same size and other color?
Blue dots.
Oh, blue is good. I think she's going to look so beautiful in blue. Do you have a ribbon to match?
I'll get the ribbon. Here's the ribbon. See if they match.
So nice.
She'll be the best dressed little girl in Kansas City.
Would you wrap this in a nice box and send it for me?
Of course. I'd like to send a letter along.
Oh, yes, a letter. But you have to wait until tomorrow, and I will have the letter ready for you, all right?
I'll have it packed real nice.
That's good. Well, goodbye, Mr. Higgins.
Settle up.
Thank you.
Oh, I thought I'd like to have another treatment, ma'am.
Does your side still bother you, Mr. Robles?
Well, I'd like to have a look at it.
Why don't you sit down and wait for the doctor? He should be back soon.
Is the doc your man?
I work for him. Right now, I'm going to make his dinner. Excuse me.
Oh, are these your living quarters?
The patients are treated out here.
Here I am.
All right. Take off your shirt.
Yes, ma'am.
Sit down. Let me see. You're quite a man.
Thank you, ma'am.
Oh, yes. Any man who can kill in the morning and still think of love, that is quite a man.
That's very nice of you.
But I would have to do one or the other, kill or love.
Well?
And I do not feel in the mood for love. You go across the room. And then we both laugh.
All right. What can I do? You stop him.
No. Take it away. My thing.
Sheriff, you left blood up there.
Is that what your friend calls sport?
I've seen it before.
All right, Billy. Your first shot. Just a nick, no hit.
Oh, that's too easy.
Too easy, maybe it is.
Let me down. Let me down, friend.
Now you got a swinging target.
Put it down, senor, so my gun arm is free. You want to draw, George?
Be careful! Put it down!
Who kind of man are you? Face down! How can you do that to a human being?
Please, help me to take him to the dock office.
You have any more games we can play, Bannister?
She didn't even thank you, did she? Come on inside. Have another drink.
Can't have everything, boy. I've got a lot to offer you, boy.
What, some more friends to shoot?
Look, you've had a big day. Dan Ritchie. Fred Jasper. Billy Dawson.
Yes, sir?
A big day.
Two more and have a poker hand.
Robles, you killed three men today. Three men I was planning to use here in Mesa, but I don't care. You killed him, that makes you better. What I do care about is getting you to throw in with me. Davey, I was a gunfighter long enough to learn one thing. Either you die young, or you grow old and end up broke. But not me. I plan to wind up alive and rich. Are you listening?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You've seen the town, Davey. It was a big one once. All the cow herds came here from Texas. Then they started going west to Ellsworth and east to Wichita. And Mesa wound up in the middle with no trade. You think this town's finished, huh? Just a few ranches around. Just a few stores in town. Well, it's not finished. Not after I take it over. Do you hear me, boy?
Oh, yeah, yeah, I hear you. You talk loud.
In Ellsworth and Wichita, they got the law. They make those Texas cowhands walk a straight line. There's no law here. A man could take all those closed-up buildings, put a saloon or a dance hall in every one of them. I'd get that Texas trade from Ellsworth and Wichita. They'd all come to a wide open town, their pockets full of trail money.
But I'm old. I need a fast gun to back me up. Like Richie's, or Dawson's, or yours, Davy boy. Why, we could...
Come on, Davy. Wake up, boy. Wake up, Davy boy. Come on, wake up. Fix you some good eggs.
Well, not the way my stomach feels.
Oh, you had a nice nap. Now for some nice food.
You know, Ed, you should have been a mother.
Well, you gotta eat something, boy.
I think I'll go and eat me some fresh air.
What about my offer?
The what?
About throwing in with me.
Oh. You know, Ed, I like your whiskey. I'm not so sure I like you.
Go ahead. Go find some more big names to kill. And if you don't get gunned down, you can grow old and see how glory tastes when you're hungry. I could make you a fortune, you fool. I could set you up for life.
Yeah. Thanks for letting me bunk you.
Wait till you grow old. Wait till you're slowed down just a fraction of a second. Then you'll wish you'd used your head to make your speed pay off when you had it.
Evening, Boozy.
Is the town always this dead at night?
Oh, Mr. Robles. Oh, no, no, not like this. Most everybody's down to town hall. Higgins called a meeting.
Say, Doc's housekeeper, what's her name?
Stella.
Stella, huh? She down at the town meeting, too?
No. She's probably down at the docks. Mr. Robles, is there anything I can do for you? Anything at all? I got your horse all saddled up and ready for you over the stable, just in case you want it.
Thanks, Breezy.
Easy, Dick.
I'll be all right.
There. Goodbye, Doctor.
Bye.
We're leaving Mesa as soon as we can pack our things. No way, this is a blessing. I'm trying to get Jack out of here alive. Bye, Stella.
Goodbye, Mrs. Dillman.
Thank you so much for your help.
Goodbye. Dog, can I fix your supper?
I've lost my appetite. I'd better get over to the town meeting and listen to Roy Higgins spout off about law and order. Do you want to listen?
No, Doc. I want to clean the office.
You go get the scissors. I'll wait for you. Ain't you invited to their meetings?
Their meetings are my meetings. If I want to go, I go. I don't want to go. I'm surprised you're still in town.
Well, I'm just staying around to keep you from getting lonesome.
I thank you for what you did this afternoon. I thank you for helping me and helping Mr. Tillman. But do not expect more than that.
Stella? I came to say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Let me give you a hand. How long you been here?
4 years.
Why?
Why not?
I don't know. Why should a deer want to join a herd of buffalo?
I like it here. I belong here. I have chosen Mesa.
Fine choice.
And where do you belong?
Oh, I belong once in Del Rio. Until four men with four guns told me you can't be safe anywhere. As long as you're weak.
And now you're strong?
Man, with this, I'm the strongest. I paid them back. With this, I can belong anywhere. With this, I could make a life for you.
For me?
A woman like you doesn't belong in a dead place like this. I could take you to Dodge, Wichita, or even Kansas City.
And that gun would make us both belong, huh? No, thank you. I have been to those places. I have had the excitement you're speaking of.
You're just scared of a little fun, that's all.
Yes. Yes. I am plenty scared of you kind, Mr. Robles. 4 years ago, I was married to a man like you. A man with a gun. We had a child in Wichita. And then one day, my husband was killed by a gun. Justice for him, maybe. But what about us? We were left without a gun to protect us. So you ride on, Mr. Robles. But you ride on alone. And if you have any decency, you stay alone.
You have a kid, huh?
Yes. In Kansas City. With her father's brother and his wife. They're very nice people. She will be here one day. I earn money. Soon I can buy a place. But more important, I earn a place here. I earn respect.
Well, adios, Linda. Oh, Breezy. Here, for the horse.
Oh, well, much obliged. But I come to get you for them at the town hall.
What?
Yeah, they asked me if you were still in town. I said, yeah. They asked me to ask you to come to the meeting.
You sure they want me?
That's what they said. You gonna go and see what they want? Huh?
Well, why not?
Sure, why not? Look, if you're tired and you want to stay overnight, I can get you a room at the hotel.
And unless you keep your wits and figure everything out with some logic, then you might as well blow up the whole town.
I agree with the doc. I agree with the
It's a bad decision. I don't like it. Ballot or no ballot.
Let Mrs. Higgins talk.
Maybe I shouldn't say anything, but I don't think we should have a man like this in our community.
Mr. Higgins is right.
Don't argue. That's decided by a vote.
Quiet, please.
I'm very sorry my wife doesn't agree with me. But we've taken a vote. No matter what Doc thinks, we've got to...
Come on, Sue.
I understand you want to talk to me?
Indeed we do, Mr. Robles. Won't you come up here, please? Mr. Robles, we'd like to persuade you to stay on here in Mesa as a town official.
Town official?
That's right. It takes fire to fight fire. And since you've proved you can handle Bannister and his friends, you are the man we want. Am I right? Isn't he?
We'd like to offer you the job of sheriff. We'll pay $100 a month and the use of the living quarters back at the jail. Now, how does that sound?
Well, it sounds fine, except that jail part.
Then you'll accept?
Well, why not? It's quite an honor. I mean, a fellow like me doesn't usually expect an honor like this. It's...
Congratulations, sheriff.
Congratulations, Sheriff.
Here's your badge.
Oh. where does it go?
Over the heart, Mr. Robles. On the left.
Yeah? How does it look?
Mighty fine, Sheriff. Now, let's see. You'll need an outfit to go with that.
Yeah, something fancy, huh?
Yes. Pants, vest, and, coat. How's this?
Hey, that's fine.
Now, how can I write if you pace around like that?
What are you putting down?
Just what you said. But either I write slow or no one can read it.
Oh, if I could only write in English.
You'd save me a lot of time. I hope the dress fits you, and I know how lovely you will look. What's next, my dear?
Is that good? I mean lovely. Maybe it should be beautiful. Oh, no, I think lovely is all right. And all my love for you, my darling, and...
Now, wait, wait, please. And?
And God bless you.
God bless you. There.
Thank you, doctor. Thank you very much. Good morning, Breezy.
Oh, good morning.
Good morning.
Doc. Doc, it's my heart. Felt a little shaky when I woke up this morning. You know, they say whiskey can help a man's heart.
So you want a drink, huh?
Well, well, what do you think? I think it would help my heart. Yes, sir, I truly do.
This kind?
Yeah, that's the kind.
Breezy, stay out of my desk and out of my liquor closet. 2 days ago, this bottle was half full. Now it's only a quarter. I found it and hid it in my office. You sneaked into my house yesterday, didn't you?
Oh, no, Doc. No, no, I wouldn't do a thing like that.
While I was here, you wouldn't. Oh. But I'm here now. That's why you had to ask me. Well, you've asked. Now get out.
Oh, now, Doc.
Out, you got Breezy, me... and stay out.
Oh, Doc.
Oh, they pinch a little.
Well, they'll loosen up.
Mm. You know, this gets in the way. How does it look?
That's the lady's style. Those sleeves could be a little longer.
Yeah. How about some hats?
Yeah, right over there. Help yourself. I'll alter this vest.
Mr. Higgins.
Hey. How do I look, huh?
Like a gambler. All you need is a pack of cards.
Yeah. Well, how do you like this one, huh?
Much better. Are you always this happy in the morning?
Why not? I've got a new job. I'm making a lot of money.
You have a new job, huh?
Hey, why didn't you stay at the meeting last night? I kind of expected your congratulations, huh?
Congratulations. Mr. Higgins, here's the letter. Now you can send the dress.
I'll put this with it and get it off right away.
Thank you very much. Good day, Mr. Sheriff.
Hey, I'll take this one.
You want to pay for it?
Put it on the books, huh? Hey, Costello. Hey, is that a nice way to treat the new sheriff? I thought you'd walk me to my office.
I think you'll be able to find it alone. You are a man who can do anything, as long as you have a gun.
Hey, you mad because I took the job, huh?
No. I don't feel angry, Mr. Robles. I just feel sorry for you.
Maybe I want some respect, too. You know, it took you 4 years. It only took me one day.
Do you really think you have respect? Only because you get $100 a month? Your gun has respect, not you. But for how long?
Well, I don't know, as long as Ed Bannister's around.
That is right. Until you clean this town up. Did you ever clean a house of rats?
What's that?
You throw a snake inside, and you shut the door. But when the rats are gone, you don't keep the snake around for company.
Hey. Hey, Stella.
Morning, Sheriff.
Hi, Ed. Oh, come on, Ed. You're gonna scratch furniture.
I can't figure you out, Roberts. Either you're a fool, like I said, or a very clever man.
Well, you take one, I'll take the other, huh?
I was kind of surprised to hear that you'd taken this job. Then I begin to wonder. Could be a good deal for both of us.
Yeah, you've been doing a lot of thinking, huh? You know what, Ed? I think you're crazy.
Why did you take it?
Oh, I don't know. I'm a sort of devoted man. You know, law and order.
What do you plan to do?
Well, I don't know. I had a shave. Bought me some new clothes. Well, I guess I'll get me some breakfast. You know, a good place.
I mean about me. You know they're all waiting for you to run me out of town?
Yeah.
Are you going to try?
No, Ed, I wouldn't try. If I wanted to, I would.
You couldn't have shined my boots 10 years ago.
Yeah, I know. You were a tiger. Ed, you tell your friends they can come to town and drink all they want. Hmm? But they tell them to stay off the streets.
I'll tell them. But I'll let them give you their answers.
Afternoon. What's all the clubbing's for?
Big dance tonight. About the only one we have all year.
That should be real nice.
Mr. Robles, you must have left early. We went by to see you. I guess you're taking a little time getting used to your job.
Well, I rode out to the neighboring ranches. Thought I'd better let them know who I am.
Well, of course. That's fine. But what about Bannister?
Oh, what about him?
Well, he's still over there.
Now, you hired me to be sheriff, right?
That's mm-hmm. right.
Well, I'm going to do the best job I can. Now, I don't think it's smart to get rid of Ed Bannister right away. You see, I have an idea that...
But that's silly. I mean...
When Bannister leaves, so does trouble.
Right. I say it's dangerous to have him around.
Well, now, the only thing you have to worry about is Ed Bannister's friends. Now, as long as I'm around... They won't bother you. See? Well, I'll see you at the dance tonight, gentlemen. Bacarillo, Bacarillo. Bacarillo, Barranqueño. Ay, qué bonitos ojos tienes. Lástima que tengas dueño. Que pajarillo es aquel que canta en aquella higuera. Anda, dile que no cante. Que espere hasta que me muera. Pero no lo miro.
Leave your hats and wraps on the table, folks. They'll be safe. Thanks. Sheriff? Tom Rule, no guns allowed at the dance.
Oh. Well, I wouldn't want to break the town rule.
Thank you.
If you just follow my instructions, I'm sure your daughter will be all right, Mrs. Jones.
Hi, Doc.
Good evening, Robles. She's a fine
girl. Nice crowd, huh?
I've never figured a crowd to be nice, just big.
Yeah. Hello.
Hello.
Whoever made this punch should be shot.
Is it bad?
Well, it ain't good.
Excuse me,
certainly. Oh, look, I ain't danced a long time. Would you like to take a chance?
I'm sorry. I have promised this dance.
Next one, huh?
It's taken two.
Oh. The same fella?
No, I have many friends. Maybe later.
Now?
I say later. Mr. Brown. Mr. Robles.
Oh, how do you do?
Hi.
I understand you rode out by our ranch this afternoon. I'm sorry I missed you.
You should have stayed home.
Mr. Brown, this is your dance.
Oh, evening, Mr. Higgins.
Evening, Chair.
Oh, is this a little woman?
Yes, it is.
You mind if we dance?
I'm sorry, but I promised my wife some punch.
Excuse me.
Sir. Well, I see Mr. Robles realized he wasn't welcome.
He'd have to be blind not to have seen it.
Just because we hired him as sheriff doesn't mean we have to accept him socially, Doctor.
Oh, I see. He's good enough to do your killing for you, but it has to be on the other side of the street.
You leaving so soon, Sheriff? Yeah, I think we're gonna get me some fresh air. Evening, Breezy.
Oh, good evening, Sheriff. Nice crowd in there.
Yeah, nice crowd. You got a drink, Breezy?
Me?
Oh. Yeah, that label looks familiar.
Yeah, well, the truth is, that's really mine, Sheriff. I left it with Tumanino to take care of it for me. I wouldn't take anything that wasn't mine.
It's all right, Breezy. Share and share alike.
You're a very understanding man, Sheriff.
Was you in the army, Breezy?
Cavalry. Yeah. You know, I once had 50 men under my command. I bet you don't even believe about the plane, do you?
Oh, I believe you, Breezy.
Why aren't you inside dancing, Sheriff?
I don't like the refreshments, Breezy.
He always used to say, when a bottle is dead, go to bed.
Yeah.
play something lively, please?
Baby. Why do you insist on staying in a mesa?
They begged me to stay, remember?
Don't you have any pride? Can't you see they don't want you?
Oh, or even I don't want them. They can keep the watered-down lemonade and the fat wives.
David, I understand your feelings.
No, you don't. No, you don't. You eat good. You bounce great. You see, I don't care whether they want me or not. I'm staying. I'm staying till I'm ready to go.
All right. Stay here. Wait for more of Bannister's friends. Kill them one at a time. Then we can thank you in our evening prayers. We can thank David Robles, our killer, who kills for us.
You really want me to go, don't you?
Yes.
Why? You think I'm not good enough for this town?
Yes. I like Mesa the way it was. Before you and you can't change it.
Because you felt pure. When I come along, you don't feel so pure anymore. You know what? You're just afraid of being a woman.
I want you.
Don't you?
Do you think I want a man who is proud to be a killer? I was married to a man like you.
Oh, what do you know about me? Why do you think I'm staying here? Why do you think I took the job? For a tin badge? For a lousy $100? Stella, I'm staying here because of you.
And what will I be? Another Nash and you gone? Something you can brag about in the saloon when you get drunk?
Blind. Go on. Go on back in there and try to forget how you feel. Only remember one thing. I know. Bannister!
Just wondering. Maybe that whiskey slowed you down a bit.
Why don't you strap the gun on and find out, Ed? You know, I could be half dead and still take you.
Why don't you take your gun off? I'd like to kill you with my bare hands. Are you man enough to fight that way?
I always said you was a little crazy. Just a second.
All right, get it over with.
No,
No, you're right, Ed. Maybe it's more fun with your fists. Only I mean it.
Just take it easy, Robus.
What are you doing?
I said take it easy. I just set your wrist. You're lucky you were out.
You set my wrist?
That's right. It was broken.
Doc, I can't move my fingers. Doc, what does it mean?
What do you mean?
Well, my wrist, will I be able to...
Can you draw a gun and shoot a man? You know the answer.
But, Doc, I got...
You're no longer a gunfighter, Robles. You're just a crippled cowboy, and the sooner you realize it, the better off you'll be.
Don't wrap it around the hand.
Suppose you keep out of my business. I want that bandage to stay tied.
I don't want it to show. Just wrap it around the wrist.
You're hoping with your shirt sleeve button that nobody can tell your wrist is bandaged, right?
Not unless you tell them. Doc, you won't tell them, will you?
I've got no reason to do that. Since you'll be leaving town tomorrow morning. Maybe this was for the best. The very best, Robles. For you and Mesa.
Thank you.
Morning, Sheriff.
Morning, Breezy.
Boy, I was thinking, Sheriff, I'd like to do you a favor.
Yeah?
I heard Bannister talking. He's plenty sore about that beating you gave him last night. Yeah, but he's expecting some more friends of his in town tomorrow. More than you can handle.
This information free, Breezy?
Well, I thought you'd appreciate it. You know, any consideration you want to make. Say, dollar?
What about that bottle last night?
Oh, yeah. Well, let's just call it a favor then.
I'll order some more of your brand, Doc.
Well, these will last me for a while, Roy.
Yes, sir. 14 men. Why, in my day, no matter where I rode, there was a...
Ed. Friend of yours?
A new one.
Just rode in this morning. It's a nice, friendly little town.
Yes, very friendly. Where are you headed for, kid?
Anywhere. Took a room at the hotel for a day or two of rest. You, must be Dave Robles.
That's right. Get out, kid.
Huh?
I said get out.
Well, thanks for the drink.
It's 9:30, Ed.
I can tell time.
That's good. Because I want you to leave town by noon. You know, Ed, someday you're going to make the mistake and draw on me. That's a single-action gun, Ed. If I hear it click, you're a dead man. Doc?
Dave, what are you doing in there? I'm going to carry you out in a box if you don't leave town. You know that boy?
I know what's on his mind. What's your name, kid?
Danny Sheridan.
You're a southpaw, huh? How many men have you killed?
Two.
Well, then you're ready for the big time. You know, you kill a big name, and you're a big name yourself. That's what you want, isn't it, kid?
Yeah.
Huh? Draw.
You're kidding.
Oh, come on. I'm giving you a chance to take my name. Wait.
Listen.
Come on, draw. Look, I don't want you hanging around wondering if you can...
Hey! Draw! Come on, draw!
Stop!
Draw!
You shouldn't have tried that.
It had to be done.
I might have to reset the wrist. Let's go to my office. Let me see that. That hurt?
Not as much now.
Well, I don't think we'll have to reset it. But you'd better wake up, man. You can't stay around like this with a broken wrist.
After Bannister leaves, then I can leave.
Who said Bannister was leaving?
I told him to.
Dave, why don't you stop fooling yourself?
When word gets out about this, you're going to be the target for every gun-happy kid in the country.
Yep.
Dave, you...
Well, it's your own life.
Don't worry, Doc. I'm going to live it as long as I can.
Doc.
You always come in the door backwards?
Oh, no. I changed my mind. I don't feel sick. Feel pretty good, as a matter of fact. Well, so long, Doc.
You think he was there all the time, huh?
I'm afraid so. Some whiskey was missing, and knowing Breezy, I...
Yeah.
I thought I'd better come over and tell you so you could do something about it.
Oh, Doc, I didn't know you was here. Oh, hello, Sheriff.
Hi, Breezy.
Oh, excuse me. I brought you word from Ed Bannister.
What kind of word, Breezy?
Well, Ed says that he ain't gonna leave town like you told him to. Instead, he says, you better leave town. And if you care to argue the point with him, he says he'll meet you in the street in 10 minutes. Well, I thought you ought to know what he said, Sheriff.
Breezy, last night we drank together. You know, I thought we was friends.
Oh, well, I don't take sides, you understand. It's just that I gotta make a living. And Ed, he can take care of...
Well, at least he gave you a break. You've got plenty of time to leave town. I'll see that Ken has your horse saddled.
Never mind.
You are leaving.
Get out, Doc.
But, Dave, I...
Leave me alone, Doc.
Hey, Breezy. Look at that old barrel shine. There's a real gun.
That it is, Ed.
You sure you told everybody to be there?
Yeah, I told Higgins, Smithy, everyone I saw. Some of them just laughed, though.
Yeah? Well, they won't be laughing after 10 o'clock.
What do you mean? Oh, you wouldn't... Shoot Robles down in cold blood, would you?
He won't be fool enough to show up. I want to show this town who's top man. That's me from now on.
Yeah, well, whatever you say.
What do you want? Another slap in the face?
With your broken wrist? David, doctor me.
This one isn't broken.
David, last time you told me you love me in your way. Now I tell you my way.
Why did you walk away then?
I don't want to share you with a gun. David, I want you.
A man who can't defend himself.
You can leave with the pride in yourself, not a gun. Please, David, go with me.
They paid me to do a job. I didn't do it.
They hired the gun. And the gun is dead. $100 is not worth dying with.
You can't make a life by running away.
Yes. Let me show you, David. Please give me a chance. I already told Ken to saddle your horse and one for me. We can go to a place, any place, and we can make a good place for you, for me, and for my daughter. Please, David, come with me. Hurry up, David, please. Come, David.
Do they know I'm running?
It is not important they know.
Good morning, Sheriff. I guess you're gonna take a little ride.
Don't listen, David. Come on, David. Please.
Go on. Clear out. One of us has to leave. I plan on staying.
Go get the horses. I'll wait here.
You wait here? Right here?
Where are you sending her, Robles? To get more help?
Don't pay attention, David. Don't pay attention to him, David, please.
You're through ordering men around. From now on, you can give your orders to women.
Come here! No! No!
Stella!
Let me go!
Stella!
To me, you scum.
I told you to make a mistake, Ed. Come on, draw.
You paid him. You paid him to get me into this. You'd never walk down here if...
Come on, Ed, draw.
It's not fair. You know you can beat me. It's not fair.
It was fair as long as you thought I was crippled, huh? Come on, Ed. Draw.
No, you don't want to kill me, Davy. Please.
You better go ahead. You bet on the wrong man, Breezy.